What if you asked people in AI? What if you were right? What if you actually succeeded in the goals that you have set for the field? And it seemed to me that almost no one was asking that question, and certainly nobody had an answer. And over the, that was in the early 90s, and over the next 20 years or so, I started to think about what kinds of answers you might have, and it became, I would say, a little bit more urgent for me when I saw Big Dog, which is the Boston Dynamics, the four-legged robot, which you see in that video where the one of their engineers tries to push it over, basically kicks this robot, tries to push it to the ground with his foot. So he's probably the first to go. It sort of recoils and stumbles and gets back on its feet again in such a lifelike way. And I had worked on leg locomotion in the 90s, and it's a hard problem. And you look at that video and you think, okay, that problem is basically solved. You know, what if we solve some of the other problems? The problems of dexterous manipulation for robots, which is another big open problem in the field. The problem of understanding language. What if we actually nail these problems? And to some extent, we've now largely nailed the problem of speech recognition. And in some ways, although in very fragile and peculiar ways, we've solved the problem of recognition of objects in visual images. And if you've ever used Google Translate these days, machine translation seems to work incredibly well. So we're starting to nail some of these problems. And so this has made me think harder. And here's the problem that I see. We have what you might call the standard model. So physics has its standard model, and AI has a standard model. And it's the same standard model that control theory has, that cybernetics has, that statistics has, that economics has, operations research. It's the same model. You create optimizing machinery for which you specify an objective. And then you hope that you got the objective right. And so interestingly, so John was talking about the book by Norbert Wiener, Human Use of Human Beings. And in that book, he says, the purpose that we put into the machine has to be the purpose that we really desire. Otherwise, we're toast. So that's the standard model. This is how we do things. So this is, you know, a big chunk of 20th century technology is based on that model. And Wiener also said that it's only human impotence that has protected us from human folly. by which he meant that our machines are so stupid and they have impacts on such a small scale that if you put the wrong purpose in, up to now, you've been able to switch them off, reset, hit yourself on the head and say, okay, obviously I forgot, I forgot about this, I forgot about that. So the question is, when machines are more intelligent than human beings, we may not have that choice.
Open the pod bay doors, Hal.
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
And even before that, so we talked about social media. So Rod was saying that we are sort of at the mercy of social media. But look at this from the point of view of the machine, right? What is the purpose put into the machine? The purpose is maximize click-through, right? Feed people stuff that they're going to click on because that's how we make money, right? And you might say, well, how do you maximize click-through? You just send people stuff that they like clicking on, right? Simple as that. Actually, that's not what the algorithms are doing. That's probably what Facebook and Google and so on thought that the algorithms were going to do, that the algorithms would adjust to the people's preferences. But in fact, that's not how reinforcement learning works. Reinforcement learning changes the state of the world to maximize the reward. And the state of the world in this case is your brain. So, what does it do? It changes you in a way that makes you more predictable so that it can then send you stuff that it knows you're going to click on. And who is more predictable than a raving fascist or a raving communist? Right? So the algorithms simply operate in a straightforward way to push, you know, so whichever side of the spectrum you're on, it's going to push you to the extreme by feeding you algorithms that are a little bit to the left or a little bit to the right of where you currently are. And it does that very efficiently and creates raving fascists and raving communists who will then lap up all of the raving content that the world can produce. And there's a whole industry, you know, that has grown up simply to feed that process. So that simple algorithm is not very smart. It's a reinforcement learning algorithm. Has possibly destroyed the EU, NATO, Western democracy. And that's just 50 lines of code, right? Imagine, imagine if it was a really intelligent system operating.